Welcome to episode 2 of our Pacific Coastal series with Celebrity Cruises. Please subscribe to our channel and select the bell to receive notifications of our new content. Thank you. After a fun night at the martini bar, coffee was quite welcome before heading out to look for whales.
First morning aboard, you know what that means? Coffee al bacchio.
Very good.
The whale watching tour operator met us at the pier and went over a bit of safety before walking us to the ship.
It's a vessel. We have the inner cabin and the upper deck. I'm just going to ask that everybody starts in the inner.
Thank you.
Captain, we just walk on board, correct? Or we wait?
Yeah, you guys can come in. I'll just take it.
After a final safety brief, we were off. When we stopped to look for whales, it made for much cleaner audio recording and easier to hear what the naturalist was saying.
Yeah, but these guys, they're kind of using our waters and our area as appetizer waters. Come back in these waters. They were whaled almost to complete extinction in this area. And then,
that
tail is a little bit bittersweet. You also have to give live birth. So after a 11-month gestation period or 11-month pregnancy, these guys will give live birth to a 3 to 4 meter long calf. So quite the task set out in front of them there.
Get back.
There we go. But yeah, so another part of the mammalian criteria, these guys are drinking that milk. So the mama humpbacks, they're producing a milk with about a 60% fat content, meaning that these guys are putting on about 5 pounds per hour or 100 pounds per day for the first little bit of their life. They're beefing up really quickly.
A film character famously said, "There be whales here." It was fascinating to get even this close to such magnificent creatures.
And lastly on that criteria, you have to have hair. So humpbacks do have hairs on the tubercles that are on their heads, so those bumps. There's 2 spit hairs in each. Those hairs can detect salinity change and temperature change, which really helps pinpoint where they are in their long migration.
Thank you.
by the way. They will attack our humpbacks. They will go after the humpback calves to feed on them.
While continuing to look for whales, our boat headed to an ecological reserve predominated by seals.
Well, I think we're gonna start moving on from these guys and maybe heading to Race Rocks.
On the way up to Race Rocks, there was one additional whale sighting, so naturally we stopped to enjoy that. This ecological reserve and lighthouse are managed by Pearson College near Victoria.
Stellars are the big guys. They get up to about 2,500 pounds and 11 feet long, whereas our Californians, they'll get up to 1,600 pounds.
He knows it's
so simple. What you'll see with the bigger guys, they don't hold their heads up high. And it's something that a lot of animals don't have. So you'll sometimes see the younger guys
This was a very enjoyable day out. Enjoy the 30-second high-speed ride back to port.
We got back from our shore excursion about an hour and a half ago or so, whale watching and seals, and it was great. It was just lovely. More seals than whales, but it was a great time out on the water. Just relaxing, enjoying the amenities of the ship, watching the harbor activity. You know, a wise man once said, cruise more and worry less. Just about the wisest words probably ever spoken in the history of history. It's a great day.
How are we doing tonight? nightclub, the Boogie Wonderland. Celebrate good times. Come on, come on and celebrate. Don't go breaking my heart. You take away our convenient drink. Oh, honey, when you knock on my door, do I give you the key? It's fun to stay at the bar.
It's morning in Victoria. We were here overnight. We had a port change, so we lost Astoria, which was to be today. Disappointing. More on that later. Quantum of the Seas and Grand Princess left last night, leaving us here overnight by ourselves. Some of you will be aware who've sailed in Alaska before or sailed in this region before that an overnight in Victoria is not only rare, but it's usually 5 or 6 hours as an excuse for a fuel stop, to keep the casinos open, all that business between the United States and a foreign country.
I stayed on board to complete filming our ship tour while Holly went to Butchart Gardens.
So nice to have you folks on board, nice to take you out to the Butchart Gardens. Hope you enjoyed your night here in Victoria.
Butchart Gardens, opened in 1921, was built on the site of a former quarry belonging to Robert and Jenny Butchart. Today there are 5 gardens on the 55-acre estate: Sunken, Rose, Japanese, Italian, and the Mediterranean Gardens. Today, the garden is still managed by Robert and Jenny Butchart's descendants.
While Holly was enjoying Butchart Gardens, I completed the filming for our ship tour, ending here at the retreat sun deck. With so few people on board today, it was certainly a good time to reflect.
Very quiet up here in the retreat sun deck. Out of 271 passengers, there are 40 in the retreat category. It's very quiet. It's also underserved, simply meaning that because today specifically, the retreat didn't open with staff right away and for their published hours. And when I came up a couple of hours ago, there was only one person up here cleaning. They were technically open. In speaking to several members of the staff, and including the retreat personnel downstairs, the anticipation of what was needed drove that staffing. So what they should have done, obviously, was had it open no matter what, because it's already been paid for. So my feeling is, whether you're in a regular cabin or in a suite, if you're trying to go to the pool, or if you're trying to go to any facility that's part of your built-in fare, that facility should be manned. So Celebrity's getting just about everything right, but not all. Just keeping it real for you.
Eventually, the service began, and I was able to enjoy a bit of Merlot before Holly returned. We then filmed our time-lapse afternoon sail away. At the martini bar after the sail away, one more whale came to say hello. We hope you've enjoyed this video. Please consider subscribing to our channel and clicking that thumbs up button. Thank you. In our next episode, we enjoy a sea day either side of visiting San Francisco. Thank you for watching.